Hello all, I am Sandhya Kiran JK from Assistant Professor, Civil Engineering Department, St. Martin's Engineering College. Today we are going to see a significant core subject of civil engineering, that is irrigation and hydraulic structures. Irrigation and hydraulic structure necessarily deals with the construction, design and analysis of the irrigational structures like reservoirs, dams, canal regulatory works, diversion networks, cross-regulatory works, spillways, energy dissipators like spilling vessels. So one of the most important topics in irrigation and hydraulic structures is the construction of dams. To begin with, the very purpose of the dam is to provide and facilitate the water to the functional purposes to humankind like irrigation and for drinking purpose and various other purposes. So, dams can be of different types. It can be of a concrete gravity dam, it can be an arch buttress dam, it can be an earth dam. Depending upon various factors and the locally available material and the site conditions, the choice of the dam is made and to construct and regulate the river water as per the necessities. Now, we are going to see in particularly the design and construction of an earthen dam. An earthen dam is centrally made up of a core material which is impermeable, whereas earthen dam requires very easily available local material such as soil, and the compaction of it is done and a very solid earthen dam is made which facilitates various purposes. But the problem with earthen dam is that the seepage, any amount of seepage of water into the dam can definitely obstruct and erect and disrupt the strength of the dam. So, as a design engineer, it is very significant to look into the amount of seepage that is happening into the earthen dam and to take the necessary care to eradicate the water and to remove it from the earthen dam. A filter which is placed at the downstream side at the toe of the earthen dam very well serves the purpose of removing the water that has gotten into the earthen dam. But to place a filter at a right position or to allow the water to be coming out from the earthen dam, it is very necessary to locate a seepage line which is also called as a phreatic line. A phreatic line is defined as a line which separates the zones of saturation and unsaturated zone in an earthen dam. A phreatic line on the above of it represents a unsaturated zone or a dry zone of soil, whereas below the phreatic line there is wet soil wherein the seepage of water is happening. From the phreatic line location, there can be a placement of filter or any other functionalities such as removal of the water can be taking place. So, there is an important author who has suggested the method of plotting the phreatic line. Casagrande has come up with the graphical method wherein, if suppose in an earthen dam already a filter is placed, how to locate the phreatic line. He has also suggested a method with, for the earthen dam to locate a phreatic line even when the filter is not placed. So, looking at this case wherein Casagrande's graphical method with filter, here he has assumed that the phreatic line is possibly looks like a parabola, and he has used the properties and characteristics of a parabola line to plot the phreatic line. Looking at this diagram, we can see there is an earthen dam with AB as the upstream surface and this side as the downstream surface, and on the toe of the downstream surface there is a filter called FE. Now we are going to plot the phreatic line over this filter. So, the first, there are three points which are necessary to locate a parabola. So, the suggestive measures help us to find out these three points, which can be C, P and G are the three points, and we are going to look at the method that how to assimilate these points. So, AB, when it is the upstream face, let its horizontal projection be L on the water surface, and we have to measure a distance BC which is 0.3 L. Then the point C is the starting point of the base parabola. So if this is 0.3 L, you get a point C which is the starting point of the parabola, and you need to extend this CB in the same direction, and CF as the radius, you have to draw an arc at this point D and drop a vertical tangent which is called as DH, which is called as directrix of the parabola. So that is what is mentioned in the second point. To locate the directrix of the parabola, use the principle that any point on the parabola is equidistant from the focus as well as the directrix. That means CD is equal to CF, and hence the vertical line directrix, that is DH, is also obtained in this step. That is, when you plot the first point at 0.3 L from the upstream face of the other dam and extend the same line to a distance where you are taking CF as the distance and dropping an arc on this extended line, and if you are drawing a vertical tangent which is becoming the DH, and you are getting the point, that is C, and the directrix DH of a parabola. Now coming to the end point, locating the end point of the parabola. The end point of the parabola is any point which is between the point F as well as the directrix DH. So any point in between this F and H is taken as G, and it becomes the end point of the parabola. So we have already obtained the starting point C and the end point G. Now it is the time to obtain the midpoint P. So again, to locate any intermediate point on the parabola, use the principle that its distance from the focus and directrix must be equal. For example, to locate any point P, we have to draw a line QP at a distance from X. So we are drawing at a distance X from the filter, you are drawing a point called PQ. And measure the QH with FS center and QH as radius. Draw an arc to cut the vertical line through Q in point P. So you will be getting a point P. If you take QH as radius and draw an arc over this line and plot that point, it is going to represent the intermediate point PX, Y. That's how you are going to get your intermediate point. And when we join the point C, P and G, you are going to get your phreatic line. So, by joining all these points, you get the base parabola. However, some correction has to be made at the entry point, and the phreatic line must be starting from B and not from C. Hence, what do? We can extend with a free hand this point, and we can plot the initial point as the point of contact at upstream as point B. Then your parabola is B, and P, G represents the base parabola. So that's how we are going to plot the phreatic line when a filter is given. Now let us solve an equation for finding out how much is the discharge happening from this phreatic line. Now, in order to find the equation of parabola, consider any point P on it with coordinates x, y, and we already have used this relationship that PF is already equal to QH, where PF is given as root x square plus y square, and QH is nothing but QF plus FH. QH is nothing but QF plus FH, then QF is x and FH is s. If we substitute that, you are going to get the value of x, and also we know the general equation of the parabola is y square is equal to 2x plus s square, and from which we can draw what is the value of s as, and at point C when x is equal to d and y is equal to h, then you are going to substitute that value of x as d and y as h, and you are going to obtain the value for the s. Therefore, as per Darcy's law, where he states that discharge per unit area is directly proportional to hydraulic gradient, which is nothing but Q is equal to KIA, and hydraulic gradient is represented as dy by dx, and per unit width of this area, if we take the area as y into 1, then the equation for discharge is going to be Q is equal to K into dy by dx into y into 1. If I am going to differentiate the equation y is equal to in terms of x, then I am going to substitute the value of y and the value of dy by dx in this equation. Then I am going to remain with the equation for the discharge here, and that is Q is equal to K into S. This is the simple expression for discharge Q in terms of focal distance S. There is Cassegrainis method for embankment with inclined discharge phase and without filter, for which there can be any number of cases where the filter can be having a angular shape, or else in any of these four shapes it can be falling in any of the four cases, depending upon which he has developed a relationship from this graph and he has given the location of the phreatic line. So that was the topic on locating a phreatic line when the filter of a earthen embankment dam is already given. Hope this will be very helpful, and we will meet with a very interesting topic next time.